This morning, thousands of flags cover the National Mall in Washington, honoring the nearly 200,000 Americans.
Patients continue to die at an alarming rate. The virus continues to take an economic
toll. Sidewalks in the Flatiron District left littered with shards of glass after rioters smashed storefronts.
This is raging across the country.
I remember the very day that we were issued the order that it was be in the best interest of the state of Ohio for everything to shut down.
Our immediate thought was, we can survive this for a couple weeks, no big deal. We'll shut down life groups, we'll shut down church, just go straight to online for a couple weeks. And so our initial thought was, no big deal. And then shortly after that, we found out, well, yes, this is going to be a big deal. And we quickly got on board with moving a lot of our stuff online, really pushing the online services, pushing online life groups, pushing online pastor's Bible study, which we've been doing since the end of March.
One of the demographics that I really noticed hit hard was teenagers, where a lot of these teenagers, especially the ones that we had seen that were making some spiritual progress, it pains me because I was in contact with them during the lockdown, and to just see how they were doing so well and then this happened, and then all of a sudden, you know, it was almost as if the lockdown had undone some of the progress that we had seen. So it was a pretty bad time.
A big part of being a Christian and attending church is part of the fellowship that comes along with that. But I didn't want to stop. I wanted to keep worshiping together in some way. And so I said, Lord, show us some way that we can do this. And it just came to my mind, Robert Schuller from the Garden Grove Community Church, An Hour of Power, how he did drive-in church services. And so immediately we got on the phone, we ordered a scissor lift, and we started having services the very next week outdoors with over 1,000 people in attendance from day one.
Scripture is very clear that you are not going to have everything go perfect in your world. In fact, Scripture promises that there will be problems. Like, you're not going to make it through life without having problems. And as we look at this one, it's shouldn't surprise us. In this world, we will have tribulation. But it goes on to say, but take heed because I have overcome. And I think what we've seen, we thought was a horrible thing for the church at first, has really been a blessing.
Could you imagine if this lockdown had happened maybe 30 or 40 years ago when technology wasn't where it is today? I mean, it's crazy to think how terrible of a situation the whole coronavirus was. However, it's been an amazing time because with the technology that's available to us today, we were still able to do ministry. We were able to reach out to the kids. And we actually started our own podcast, which is something that we've been thinking about doing for a long time. And we would just make these videos and put them on YouTube and invite the kids to tune into it. And some of it was fun stuff. A lot of it was, we would do messages and we would do a prayer time and stuff. But it's just, it's amazing that even in this dark time, I do feel like God has equipped us to handle it in a ministry sense.
We've seen people that did not prioritize church come out for services in the parking lot and in person and online. And we've seen people begin their relationships with Christ during this pandemic, where I think out of the last 6 weeks, someone's come to Christ through one of our Sunday morning weekends. And just to see the focus when everything else has been stripped away, to see the focus put back on our Lord Jesus Christ has been amazing.
Sometimes it's easy to self-fear during a time like this in a pandemic. How we're to move on, the world is looking for people and churches, I believe, that'll be steadfast, whether they're doing it live stream, whether they're doing it in the homes or in the church, to keep our focus on Jesus Christ, that we have orders to share the gospel with people. So we still are, our missionaries are active. We're part of the Southern Baptist Convention. We have 11,000 missionaries still on the field during this COVID season. In the midst of all that we do, we take the stand of the Apostle Paul. He says, having done all to stand, then stand. And with God's help, we're going to keep standing for the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I think we're all ready for 2020 to be over. But I think what we've set ourselves up through, not knowing, because it's only through the grace of God, that we've experienced a small revival here at the church, where we've, like I said, seen people come to the Lord, many. We've seen people have a stronger focus on giving, on serving, and really building their life around the church, where before church was just an add-on. When you take that and you couple it with the brand new building that we'll be opening in July, I think we're primed for a revival for our community. The community is looking for hope. We have the answer of hope. And through the grace of our Lord Savior Jesus Christ, I can't wait to see what will happen in 2021.
I guess one of the things that I want for this coming year is that we can just ride this momentum that we're riding. And what I mean by that is, you know, youth ministry is full of fun events, right? We go on mission trips, we go to camp, we'll go to like winter camp for the weekend, and it's just, it's really fun, it's awesome times. But often we can make it about the event and less about God. And I'm not saying that that's what happens, but it is easy to slip into that trap. And with the lockdown and having to cancel camp, having to cancel our mission trip this year, it caused us to really kind of reset and refocus. And taking everything out of the picture has caused us, I think, to place our eyes solely on Jesus. And I would say that's been the biggest benefit to come out of this terrible time. And so my prayer for 2021 is that we can continue to keep our eyes fully on Christ. That when we start doing this other stuff again, we've built a foundation that rests solely on Christ. It's going to be an awesome year, and I'm looking forward to it.
As Christians and followers of Jesus Christ, we never sit still in times of darkness. We pray, we put our faith in Him, and we continue marching on.
Let our praises remind all the darkness of how great and how mighty our God is. For the battle belongs to the Lord and no one else. We are standing in holy defiance. We're declaring aloud in the silence that the battle belongs to the Lord and no. The troubles, the trials, the shadows, the sorrows, the long nights, the hard fight. We are the prophets, the voice in the darkness, declaring the battle is yours. We'll sing hallelujah for all hell to hear. Shout out Hosanna above every fear. Strongholds will crumble like castles of sand. We are marching on.
Here we go. Oh my God. Matt, are you okay? I got you.
We're marching on.
We're marching on.